You could just make that count. You could just make the countdown. Put up a fake countdown. Just put like a fake countdown underneath the bungee countdown. Yeah. Because we don't actually know what the countdown is going to, other than said be 30. Anyway, hello everyone. Welcome, 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 welcome back. Cado, you made it back through.
Hello.
Traffic Eclipsacopolis. It sounds like you ran into a lot of traffic coming back from your.
A mistake. Well, it wasn't a mistake. It was worth doing. But a 6-hour car trip, which is already going to be kind of long, got us home around like close to midnight, or 13 hours of driving?
So when did you actually get home?
Close to 4 a.m.
That's not
cool. I haven't had coffee yet.
What are you doing? Like, get your life together. Like,
I know.
Just give them priorities.
I ordered food. That was probably the more important thing than coffee. I could have gone and got coffee, though.
Kyle, before you get coffee, turn down the music knob on the stream that people are saying. We need to be louder. The people want to hear us, Kyle.
That makes sense. I forgot to give us the audio. Here. Now you hear it?
I meant for the people listening.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's all the same pipes. I just forgot to give it to us. Okay. So I'm like, what audio?
Did you get you're in Florida, correct?
I was in Florida last week visiting my family. Which was nice.
Did you go to the Totality?
Yesterday, yes. I went to the Totality. Went north of New York. Straight, gotta get right in the middle. Otherwise, it's not worth it, right? Like, at like degrees like 99 through like 90, it's all basically the same. Like, it doesn't really matter. Totality is the only thing.
Go fuck yourself, Patrick, and whatever you experienced yesterday. If you enjoyed it at all, I guess.
Look, I'm not saying that it's not good or interesting. I'm saying.
We picked up on what you were putting down, Cado.
Not the same. It was amazing, though. I got a freaky ass video of it happening, like the last seconds. I'm just like, oh shit, it's weirdly dark now. That's kind of fucked up. No wonder people thought the Earth was like ending when this shit used to happen before they knew how to predict them.
Yeah, I have. I get the weirdest advertisements on Facebook. Now, which I only go on there to share pictures of my kids with, like, extended family. It's, like, the primary use of that platform at this point. But then as you're there, you just get the weirdest, worst ads. Like, there was an ad, like, you know, things were getting eclipse-themed as we were leading up to this. And one was, like, ancient history facts. It was like, did you know that in this ancient battle, like, the reason it stopped and peace was achieved between these warring factions was because a total eclipse occurred, and it was the first time a cosmological event influenced a battle. I'm like, I have no idea if that's true.
Is this real?
But it sounds right. Like, that could be true. It sounds plausible.
It's totally
plausible. But I have
no
idea. Yeah.
Having experienced it, yeah. I would stop fucking fighting if that shit happened to me while I was like, what the fuck is going on? Someone up there doesn't want us to do this shit.
If you just joined the stream, people might be asking, I don't see that countdown timer anywhere else. It's because we made it up.
It's not real.
We don't know when this starts. We just thought
it's
false. We think Bungie should have a countdown timer, and so we put one on there. Cado, you'll have to go back and look. Yeah. I found my own countdown timer.
Oh yeah,
and added it to my stream. It was a very good countdown timer. Everyone.
Oh no! What have you done? What have you
done?
People liked it.
People loved it.
I believe you. I don't believe you.
So we're here to watch this Final Shape developer gameplay preview, which will be the first time we're seeing like what is the Final Shape going to actually look like. It means that Patrick gets to go through the Sonic cycle
Woo!
Again, which I realize now That's my Sonic cycle is Destiny. This time, it'll be different. Probably not.
No.
But boy, we're going to put in 30 to 35 hours finding out and then go, yeah. Huh. That's about where we were last time. but I do want to see. Oh, I do want to see how this story ends. All right, here we go.
Hey, everyone. This is Luke from the Destiny.
Oh, team. Hey!
The final shape is the culmination.
What are you doing, Luke?
I don't text about Weezer journey. Albums with that guy. Wouldn't do that. That'd be a weird thing to do.
To the moon, Venus, Mars, the reef, and beyond.
It's been a minute since we've seen
it. The journey that'll end inside the Traveler with you facing the Witness. But facing the Witness is not the end of Destiny 2. And it's definitely not the end of Destiny. After you face the Witness, we're going to tell you what's coming next to Destiny 2 and beyond. We'll see you soon.
He's working on the and beyond, thanks. Right?
Dude, I don't know. I also don't ask him.
No, I mean, like, I thought that was the thing. The like, he's not really on Destiny.
Yeah. Right. Post Taking King, Luke took on a bigger picture.
The amount of all
sort of role at not
only
at Destiny but also at a
I was like, are you guys seeing this?
It looks awesome.
So the nice part is, even though I chat with Luke fairly regularly, I don't know what's going on in Destiny. Can't ask you for any information if I don't know what to ask. Mostly just talk about our kids.
That good?
I think just go in it.
I mean, that's what we're gonna do, right? Oh, no, something came out of it.
Ah, the subjugator of gardens. That's what I call the little bugs around all my plants in the summer. Ah, damn, time to fight the subjugator of gardens.
Hold on. Did I see that right?
What? You gotta use your words, Cado. What are you seeing?
Hold on, I'm lost. I feel like I saw something that I shouldn't have seen. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, that was. Yeah, no, that ability is from a different subclass. That's what's going on here. Hold on.
Wait, like they're mixing and matching abilities?
Yeah.
Into the parts of the Traveler.
Wait,
and
Cado?
You, the
what was my big problem?
It's empowering us with
the grapple hook was cool. Only one ability.
Don't look at the rest of this class.
Created this very evocative image.
Can I have a war hook?
A guardian with light armor and dark armor.
We're like, we really need this in the final shape. This is the ultimate form of being a guardian to wield light and darkness at the same time. We build Prismatic exactly to be
Prismatic.
That.
Prismatic is the new subclass in the final shape where you can combine certain class abilities from different damage types.
Getting light and dark mastery. No one's done that before. Like the Witness is manipulating the energies like this, but the Witness is not a master of light and dark. You are. The Guardian is.
All right, that's pretty good. All right, look, they got their literal hook in me again.
Yeah.
God damn it.
They did it.
Damn you, Sam Dunn, whoever you are.
Light damage or dark damage, it fills the respective sides of the meter. Once both sides are full, you get this new level of power that we're calling Transcendence.
I love Transcendence because you do these cool motions.
For Warlocks, we have this cool, like, mystic pose. Hunters are going to do this cool, like...
The Titan one where you just go.
While you're transcendent, you get a new, unique grenade.
I'm already like,
no, really?
I'm already like building in my head, like, oh, fuck. It doesn't feel like it's balanced currently. I wonder what.
Stasis and void together.
What if fuck balance, Cado?
I think that's probably what they're doing, actually.
Damage bonuses.
They've kind of been leaning that way for the PvE stuff a lot. It's just like, you're gonna break something? Fucking so break it, I guess. Together, one
after the other. I mean, like, they're...
That's,
you know,
really exciting.
That is so good.
If post-final shape is some sort of, like, reboot, you know what I mean? Like, is this a chance to just, hey, emphasize, like, fun experimentation, and then we'll see what's next after that?
I think what might be happening is probably some sort of light balancing through which ones you can pick together, probably.
I don't know. I'm just the art director. I think that prismatic feels like you are doing combinations you shouldn't be able to do.
It feels a little game breaking.
It looks like it. It looks like
a little bit. Yeah.
Now, granted, they did say certain abilities, right?
Right.
Like it sounds like you're not going to mix and match everything.
You're
right.
Gonna be like, oh no.
But even some of the things that we're seeing in this, where I'm like, oh, you can put those, smash those two together. That seems.
Mm-hmm.
Well, but they've done this. There is a certain level of sort of like ads, like power creep that's been happening in Destiny, where it's just like the game. We've gotten really good at killing a lot of small things, so they just keep pumping up the amount of small things, which is cool in certain ways, right? Because then you can get through. It's less about like a damage check. It's more about how do you manage
kind of the bounds the amount of light and darkness.
There's all these
subclasses that really resonate with people, and now you can finally combine those and make your own guardian feel very unique to you.
This like really opens up the doors for unexpected, like really wild stuff.
I love being a hunter and having gunpowder gamble and blowing them up. And then we're like, oh, wait, what if you could slow enemies? You could throw out, you know, your shurikens. And then
this
you
has strong,
well.
Like okay. Bungie did a game jam. And someone was like, what if I just like let people,
I can do as much as I
what
want?
If we just let them
screw around with their classes?
Melee and like bounce it between a bunch of people and get like 3 kills from one melee, and now your gunpowder gamble's like fully charged, right? And so like certain interactions I think get a lot easier just because we've sort of made the aspects a little bit more permissive, a little bit looser.
A little loosey-goosey.
Huh.
So
we got a little bit of a don't give a fuck attitude here at Bungie right now. If the Final Shape doesn't perform, who knows what this studio looks like? So we might as well go all out for this one.
Yeah.
Bleak Watcher on top of that for just like a little extra.
Like not to make it bleak, but you know, the future of Bungie is really feels very up in the air right now.
To stay in the fight,
which feels very different from
just quickly start using
the previous expansion, the acquisition by Sony, where it was like, wow, they're going to Sony, so they can do like whatever they want without having to worry so much about X, Y, and Z. And now we're in a place where. The studio feels very vulnerable to
that
you can the ebbs and flows of the next couple of months, and that's just a. I wonder how much that is tied up to decisions like this.
Creates these where, moments of escalation within the combat.
Let's have fun. Really let's have the community have fun. This is such a culminative moment for.
You consume your
destiny as an idea going back to the original game.
And so it's, you know, locking stuff down with stasis.
Go out on your own terms. Have some fun.
Clean that stuff up pretty easily.
And
with,
like,
you know, an arcane needle melee, which has 3 charges.
It feels
those
like they're
kills will activate devour,
looking
which
back.
Gives you more grenade energy every time devour
like
activates.
This whole thing so far is like,
watcher. And so
imagine being
like
a new person watching this and trying to parse anything about what's going on.
Like, no, I'm not a new person. That's how I
you're new enough. You're new enough.
This is why I have you here. And I can already conceptualize that when this expansion comes out, we're going to do a stream where we build a Patrick, not a mech, but a Destiny class. We're going to go through what I got, what do I like to do, you and I are going to figure that out together.
All the players like talk about their favorite combinations. I'm just looking forward to all the videos that people make of their own custom builds with their
own. But so like
it
definitely feels like this is very like
to create like this
old head
these amazing
first.
Builds. It feels infinite to me.
Well, and that does make sense, really, right?
Yeah, like exactly. Yeah.
Who are you aiming at with the finality of Destiny 2's?
It's got to be old.
You know, current storyline arc. It's the people who have always shown up. They might be angry at you most of the time, but they show up.
Yeah. Well, and that's the thing. Those people showed up for Lightfall and then like fell off afterwards.
Right. I mean, that was me. Right.
Like I haven't played Destiny since Lightfall.
Vice hasn't taken down our articles yet, but you know, the final piece I wrote about my experience with Destiny was, you know, shooting that boss in the leg underneath a set of stairs for 90 minutes.
Yeah. Just understand there's gross things happening on the screen. For most of this so far.
In the final shape, we're going to be making these new exotic class items.
And that's what makes me wonder about what is Destiny post from the final shape. Is it, and hey, two perks this is now explicitly something that just targets the hardcore. Like, new, like people who float in and out of expansions, you are released. The game is, you know what I mean? Like, I don't, or is it a chance to reset things and create a new normal? I don't know.
Right.
These new class items are all about prismatic. Whoa. And making that feel good.
They look cool.
So it's gonna be all about enhancing your builds and your combination of light and darkness and achieving transcendence and what transcendence does. They also look so good.
With these class items, we wanted them to stand out as special. They have these two perk columns that take aspects from other exotics.
Exotic class items are gonna let you do things that other classes consider their own, but now they're yours. I managed to get, for my slow them down, blow them up hunter build, a roll on the exotic cloak that made it so powered melee kills caused enemies to ignite.
Oh, and no, it's
also
a roll.
I could get an extra dodge.
Bastards.
Charge, so I could do
it. You
extra
made something I have to hunt.
At the same time.
You fools.
We wanted to feel a little broken.
What does that mean? Explain what you mean
like
by that.
So on my cloak, which is kind of the
it sounds like they're getting perks from other exotics onto these ones that can combine things. But it sounds like the way to get them is through random rolls.
For
like
mix and matching in a way
you have
that
to unlock the item and hope it gets the two perks that you would like.
Find and lie.
I'm curious
and
because like
for the build that you're trying to do, yeah.
Right, and like I bet there's probably a way to craft it. Crafting has become such a central part to
they
like
look amazing.
Making
they
builds
have
and stuff.
Visual effects.
I
that
would assume there's some way to
transcend
choose those perks
it
eventually
really
through enough
this overall
like,
theme.
Grinding of it.
But on top of that,
that's
the
kind of the way they it's like initials are always random. Eventually, you unlock
exotics,
the ability to craft your own specific
classes
ones
that
with
aren't
materials and stuff.
You
so.
Adds this element of spice to them, and the fact that it's random rolls. You're going to want to keep looking for the right one.
See?
For your build.
I don't know. There may be too many exotics that exist for, like, how many combinations about that? how long am I hunting for the exact two that I want? Out of the, like...
As long as it takes, Cado.
Strand and Stasis are the only darkness powers we've got. Yeah. Isn't theory prismatic?
The dread are this new.
Then what do you think is the point of individual classes then? Or is this sort of a compass that points in the direction of ultimately classes
new,
meaning less
see,
and
like,
less to the
that
like,
we've been building
long-term
the
future
that
of the game?
Connects it all together.
I do think that that's kind of what their point, right? Like it's called the final shape.
You've
I think
seen a member of the dread before.
Ultimate sort
you
of
might
like
remember. Seeing the Tormentor make a big appearance last year.
Theological like thesis that they're making in the end is like actually dark light, like
you
it's
have, like, this
kind
of
made up
of new
made up
like, the
divisions
and, the
and
subjugators and the
being able to pull on
the
all of these powers
the
aren't isn't inherently evil or good.
This is like the
right like
mm-hmm.
There's been a lot
of
like
these new
you know the
enemies.
Guardians aren't all good just because they use the light. The our enemies aren't all bad just because they use the dark.
The Grim is probably
so
one of my
it makes sense as a it makes sense like
let me use it.
Exactly.
It's a poster child. Of
it makes
the
sense
ways,
from where we've been going that at the end we come out the
gun
other
gun
side
yes,
with
exactly.
Like you're able to use all of it and like mix and match and like it's about what you do with
screen,
it, not
the swoops all around
cool,
the
yada,
battlefield.
Yada. And so
it's a profile we've never seen in Destiny.
You are facing
I wonder if
now,
they act if it, it acts ends up acting more like
with
you know you learn the individual ones first and then the last
screech and if
that's the new
you,
like progression
suppresses your
as you unlock individual classes
right.
In order to unlock them for the multi-class it's option at the end
appealed to
you
the
can
team.
Make
well
match,
oh
we
so
be,
you're saying
we have to make this character
already I know it's only been a couple of weeks, but Dragon's Dogma 2 has infiltrated all the video games.
No, they were actually looking at Dragon's Dogma 1. They were looking at Dragon's Dogma 1.
Folks, we feasted. Folks, we feasted. We did it.
They heard.
I lived long enough for Dragon's Dogma to take over game design.
And they just come charging with those things, and we'll just slice and dice.
You can take me now.
They are.
I mean, don't. My kids got a dance recital in June. But after that, we're in Dragon's Dogma peaking. We're good.
Because if you kill it the wrong way, what's inside of the husk? The geist is gonna pop out and it's gonna seek you out.
Gross.
A guy don't like that. Me. More than I care
so, some people are pointing out this is the first time we're seeing like a really like a new enemy type in a long time.
Somewhere because I'm targeting that first.
Yeah, it's been a minute.
What does a minute mean?
I mean, Lightfall had some new
stuff.
The
attendant are our Strain and Stasis scions that have been reshaped by the witness.
2 years.
We wanted to show like, the influence of
some stuff.
Darkness powers on these characters.
It was mostly in the raid,
they
I guess.
They have a stasis ability that can shoot at you that will freeze you.
Oh,
they
so I didn't. Okay, so. How long for me since I've seen a new enemy type, Cado?
No, I mean, there were the big. There were the boss versions of these enemies, right? Like, there was like that. Mm-hmm. The one that would, like, chase you around a bunch.
Shoot out this complete
like the sort of
strand wave.
Darkness.
If that thing hits you, it's almost like a rubber
minions
band. It like pulls back.
Did exist in there, but they weren't like a lot of them.
Snaps,
they were like one specific boss type.
That character. As one character.
Forsaken added
that
Scorn.
You,
right. Yeah, Scorn, which is
as soon as there's multiple characters trying to pull you in different directions towards you, you have to approach it in a different way.
Wow, I can't remember their fucking name. The Elixni. What's the real name?
We're really excited about everything that we've been doing for the final
Not
shape.
The real name. The
it just
the
feels
fake
like there's
name.
A really cool through line.
The Fallen.
All of
Jesus.
This.
Look, I remember.
It's the culmination of the Guardian's journey.
And this is, it's even worse.
The Fallen.
Kind of like Austin, Austin is just in the cat apoplectic that you can't pull basic Destiny vocabulary.
Well, but the fucked up thing is I remember the Elixni. Their actual name. Not the Fallen, which is what the Guardians call them.
In the final shape.
I couldn't remember the original. The one that we were calling them originally. The Fallen. Scorn is like Fallen Twisted. This does look like a lot newer than anything like that.
Cado sounds like you might be the Fallen. The Fallen one. The Fallen Cado. A Fallen Cado appears. Into
our annihilation. Let me play an Elixir. I think the Elixir are playable in after whatever happens after the final shape. They could just dual wield. It's fine. New power. I can feel it. See, we have two hands and we got one gun. The Elixir have four hands, so they can use two guns. That's how math works.
Oh.
Very good. Yeah, some gross shit is happening. Let's just say. Take this power, Guardian. FMA Mustang snaps. Yeah, they added that about a year ago, year and a half. It's very good. It's very fun. Oh, that's fucked up. Okay, no, that's gonna be a problem in PvP.
Well, that's one thing I've noticed about people in chat noting is, EVP maybe already not in the best shape from a balance perspective, and now you just introduce a bajillion different variables.
Yeah. Isn't that looks neat? Ah, fuck. Oh, hey, this is the thing that's happening today.
Right, so this is the bridge, right? This is what's going to take us into the final shape.
The forces of the witness surge at the borders of the city. Lord Shax has been authorized.
Oh, hey, look, it looks like the game looks now.
An arsenal of banned weapons from his personal collection.
Hey, Shax.
Back into circulation.
Powerful gear for a powerful guardian. Good luck.
New wave defense activity. Who'd have guessed it?
Careful with that.
Weapons we once deemed heretical.
What are you trying to say, Cado?
We now see as desperate measures.
Look, I love Destiny, but every activity is a wave-based activity just because that's what they designed. A wave-based gameplay loop. It's like, you could have just said Destiny activity. It would same words.
Damn.
Magnificent. Nice.
Holofoil. This is neat, actually. These missions were so fucking cool. They were missions specifically to unlock two exotic weapons that got vaulted when the locations that they existed on were vaulted.
Right.
But as missions themselves were really, really neat, so I'm glad they're bringing them back so people can unlock those exotics again and also experience those missions for the first time. They're very, very cool.
I'm Weasel09. This is really please come back the patch.
Yeah.
Is that the sense that you get as well from like some of these changes that they're making more broadly?
I love to see it.
Yeah, especially heading up. It's like they did as much as they could to kind of like entice people to be like, hey, something's happening. But it is also like a little bit of a last, like, if you were new and are like were sad at some of the things that were missing, here's a chance to get some of those things that you missed because you weren't here the whole time, right? Into the Light is very much the, if you missed the first time all these broken guns were around to unlock, here you go. You get to unlock them now. And also here's these cool exotic things that you missed out on the first time around. There's like that Into the Light is there like, newer players, please come back. And the final shape is older players, please come back. Please, for the fucking love of God, please come back.
Well, kind of. I think as a result of this stream, you and I have unlocked a very rare exotic called Buckshot.
Oh, no.
We're gonna transition over. Kato and I are gonna check out Buckshot Roulette. If you don't know anything about this game, you should stay that way. I played about 15 minutes of this personally before I thought I should just play this on stream with somebody. So if you want to come hang around and watch us check out Buckshot Roulette, that's what we're going to transition over to now.
Goodbye, Destiny.
That's well, not yet, Cado. That happens in June. Then you can say goodbye to Destiny.
No, the fucked up thing is that if it's really good, I might be back. It might be Hello Destiny. Because it has been a minute. It has been a minute.
This is Buckshot Roulette. It's a game that came out in some form a while ago, and then now has come to Steam in an updated form. I don't know. I didn't know anything about it. I saw like a video of a clip of it a couple of weeks back, and then sort of set aside that I think this is probably a game that would be fun to play on stream. And Cado, you said you played at least a version of this. I don't know if it's this version. I don't know what's different.
No.
Apparently
on the itch version, which is the one that I own, the Steam stuff will be uploaded on the 18th of April. So like I will eventually unlock this. But currently,
okay, so this will at least be somewhat be fresh new. For both of us. Yeah. So Buckshot Roulette is a... Well, let's just get into it. I feel like Buckshot Roulette explains itself. Strong Inscryption vibes, for sure.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Afraid? No. Afraid that I'll like Destiny? Yes.
No fears. The final shape comes out. One fear.
This is how we're gonna feel when the final shape drops, Cado.
Woo!
Classes?
Who needs
this? This is a classless society over here. Destiny is very political. It is said that classes don't matter.
Classes don't matter, yeah. Fuck. I need a drink. I'll be right back.
Yeah, it's called the coffee. Oh, Cado actually did leave. Okay, well now I have to wait for, and I I have to wait for Cado to come back. You don't get a lot of letters.
I mean, if y'all can hear this. Yeah.
Yes. What did you just open?
A Topo Chico. Lime with mint. Flavored water. Oh. Sparkling okay. water. Mm. It's like, what if a margarita really didn't have alcohol in it?
See, I like the alternative that you're actually just following in the footsteps of Rob Zachney. He's like, so I haven't had coffee, and I haven't slept. Time to start day drinking and see where the day goes.
See, we're on this ride already. Let's make it fun. Oh my god.
Who are we?
Who are you, Patrick?
I can't fit my full name, so we'll be Pat.
Oh, they only give you how many letters?
Discriminating against the amount of letters Pat. In my name. Well, when I was a kid, my mom was afraid that I'd get made fun of. Oh, I didn't read that. Was it one blank?
One live round, two blanks.
My mom was afraid that I'd be made fun of for like having the name Pat, and so she was like very like, call him Patrick, and if you called me Pat, you put a quarter in a jar.
Wow.
And then she gave me the quarters.
Sick.
Well, people learned pretty quickly. It didn't last that long, so I guess it was effective from my mom's perspective.
Right.
So the way this game works, you know, you've got, you know, two health over here. If you shoot yourself, you're hoping it's a blank. If you shoot if it's a blank, you skip the dealer's turn. So that's kind of the bet that you are making. So what do we say? Sorry, two live rounds, one fake?
One live, two fake.
Well, one live, two fake. I feel like I have to.
Mm-hmm.
Those are good odds. I'm shooting myself.
Yeah. Now, before you shoot yourself, do you want to change? Now you got a Monty Hall problem. There you go. You did it.
Okay. So now it's 50-50. Now it's 50-50. Now if I shoot myself, that's no good. I feel like I shoot him. I feel like I should. Shooting,
I think,
I'm gonna shoot him.
Yeah.
I mean, you could just keep doubling down. I mean, 50-50 is good odds. Like, those are good odds.
It is. But then you're behind and then it's his turn.
I am behind. So I feel like I need to just... You gotta risk it. No risk it. No biscuit.
Oh, so this is the wine scene from The Princess Bride, the game. Yes.
God
damn it. You hate to see it. However, now it's gonna... You still take a damage... But it's your turn again, I think, right? That's how this works?
Three live rounds, two blanks. I almost need to like write this down.
Spicy.
Like,
You need a notebook. Was Rob Zachney correct? Do we just need more paper in our lives? Or
no, I don't, I
do you ne- need a tablet?
I never write this.
Paper-like tablet?
This notebook goes all the way back to what would a date be? Well, here's a great these are lore reasons notes.
Oh my god.
This page fell out.
No.
This page fell out.
What is that? I can't.
I'm trying to get the
too
yes,
bright.
These are all. I know it's too bright.
And tilt it forward. Are... Tilt the top forward. There you go. Ventus. Oh fuck, Ventus.
I don't know what any of this means. So anyway, that tells you where we're at in this notebook. Like that's mm-hmm. how far this goes back, and I have not gotten
spectacular.
Oh, I've got some notes on the witness. Fuck that game. I've got notes on when I talked to Fumito Ueda.
Oh.
Probably for the last Guardian.
Mm. Yeah. Ow.
What has it been like to watch so many people take so many designers take inspiration from some of your games? I don't know. Did that end up in an article? Did I ask that?
Probably.
I'm not sure. Oh, Evangelion notes. Ugh. Ugh. All right.
Today? Gaming Gumper? Is that today? Shut the fuck up. 2 year anniversary what? Since KH4 was announced.
Since what was announced?
Kingdom Hearts 4.
Oh. Where did I put the pen? I had a pen.
Literally today. There's no way. That's very okay. Funny. Funny if true.
Three live, two blanks? Is that where we're at?
Three live, two blanks. One live, one blank out, right? Is that what just happened? No, three lives, two blanks. April 22.
Yeah, those are the previous bullets, right? Those are not new. Three lives, two blanks. It's a lot of lives.
It is a lot of lives.
Two blanks. What do you think, Cado?
I mean, you have to play the odds, right? There's more lives than blanks. You shoot the other person.
Yeah, so I think I shoot him. I think it's
gonna fuck you though. Oh no, we're good.
Well, but he's one ahead of me. It's hard getting one behind so early in the game.
We just have to hope he's wrong.
Fuck yeah. There we go. Okay, all right, cross that out. Round done. Godato, is it not just 60-40? Is there logic to deriving the order? There is eventually logic to deriving the order, or at least that can be... The order can be influenced, I guess is what I will say.
Here comes the first escalation.
Oh, do I put it here? Okay. So we got two smokes, which I believe is just a plus one health, right? This is about kind of as far as I got before I turned this off. The dealer has a knife, which will kind of like turn it into a sawed-off shotgun, and it turns the shotgun from dealing one damage to two damage.
Uh-huh.
And then I forget what the beer does. I don't remember what that item...
The beer, I believe, racks it. So you, like, pump the shotgun, which ejects the current...
Oh, it ejects one. Yeah. So you can see if it's a blank or a live round.
Mm-hmm. So I have theory here.
Yeah.
I want to get into it.
Sure, theory. Hit me.
Well, you have two heals, right? So going down by one isn't the worst thing you could do right now. So...
Sure.
It's a 50-50. You'd shoot yourself.
Wait, what's our count at?
I one and one. That part. Just one and one.
Oh, just one and one?
Just one and one. If you shoot the guy and it's a blank and it goes to his turn, he knows it's live. He can use the sawed off. You get two hit points. That's bad. You shoot yourself, it's a single. You take one smoke. No big deal. If you shoot yourself and it's a blank, boom, you're winning. So the only option is to shoot yourself. That's logic, baby.
There it is.
Beautiful.
So now we know it's a live round. We can't this. So we have the knife. This would be a good time to use it, obviously, to take down two. But we don't. So we just take it. We shoot. And then we reset the.
Boop. And get more items.
And we continue to stack our items. Oh, I haven't gotten this one. Okay, well, that's not helpful.
Mm.
All right. 50. Two live, two blanks. Oh, dealer skips the next turn. Oh, that's pretty good. So you can try and use that. he just can't see. The magnifying glass. Oh, I forget what that does.
I think that lets them look at the current.
You can see what's inside. Yes, you can see if it's a one, which. Yeah. So I mean, we're at a coin flip. I think the logic still applies of the last round of.
Basically, yeah.
We shoot ourselves and we can try and recover our health and try and use that to give ourselves an early advantage.
With the lock though, you could use that, right? Just to, even if you're wrong, it's still your turn. You still have control over it.
Can I back? No. I think escape? Once I've hit escape? That, I think no. Escape is. So I think maybe I'm locked into it. Okay, well that's good to know from a UI perspective. All right, here we go. Well, that's
unfortunate.
Ouch. So now we're down to one live, two blank. He's probably going to shoot himself. He's going to look. He's going to inspect it.
He made a mistake. They're both.
Oh, so now it's two blanks. Blank.
It's one blank. There it is. It's over.
But he skips my turn.
Yeah, because he knows it's two blanks.
Yeah.
It should be his turn again next.
I believe so. It should carry over.
Ah. 3-2.
Okay. 3 live, 2 blank.
Oh no, we get to.
We have a lot of board control options, and we're gonna run out of space here. So. What did you say?
Did I say something?
Maybe not.
It was 3-2.
Maybe
right?
Not.
Is this an inscription? Yeah,
3 live, 2 blank. So
just vibes wise, I think it is. You want to maybe look? No, because I guess
as well.
3-2. It's more likely to be live than not. But if it isn't, you
correct.
Don't... The only good thing that happens if you use the magnifying glass is if it is live, you can use the sawed off to do 2 damage on purpose.
Yes. And if it's not,
like, but then if it's not, you skip him, and then but you don't have any more information. But we have two.
So it might be useful to use that after the original round, where you can control more of the back half of.
Right. I was gonna say after, like, we have two ways to skip his turn, and no matter what happens to us, right? So we might as well do that. We should also probably heal, just to be back at full.
Well, yeah, and he's got these
doubles.
He's got two. So we probably take the gamble on the live shot, and then we see where we're at from there.
I would lock him up as a backup for if we shoot ourselves, still having control over the situation.
So you think we should shoot ourselves?
Yes. Yes, okay. Yes, yes.
Well, that one way or the other, that allows us to control the rest of
Of
bullets.
Shoot him, because normally what would happen if we miss?
Right,
because
it's going to skip his turn anyway. Otherwise, we're just wasting the item.
Yeah. Right. That was the logic. Right. There we go. There it is.
Get him. Fuck.
Well, we use the.
All right. One blank, 3 live. Now. We could use the magnifying glass to
be sure.
Know one way or the other, right. To be sure, and then we could use the if we've got a live one.
Yep.
All right.
Yep.
I love that you just break it. All right, we got a live one. Then we use the handsaw. And then we get his ass.
Boom.
All right. 2 live, 1 blank. He's not happy about it. He can't recover any health.
Gonna rack it once. That's the blank shit. Gone.
Damn it. There's one more live one. So we ultimately win the round.
Yeah. This is fine. Yeah, well now we know. We don't even gotta do anything, just bam. Lap.
Oop.
Lap.
Okay. All right. We're now further than I got in the time that I played by myself.
Oh, nice. Hat wins.
Hat wins. I mean, that's what I'm always saying, you know?
Uh-oh. That seems bad.
I saw that they're working to add a multiplayer mode to this, which this game desperately needs. Ooh. It would be a very good multiplayer game.
Yeah. Then you're talking mind games.
Four items each. Does our health reset?
Don't know. It might.
These are both good items to have.
Yep.
Oh, we're happy. We're really happy, I think.
I would have loved the magnifying glass.
No inscription. Yeah. All right, one live, two blanks. It says no defib, so one health? No, so what does no defibrillator mean?
I think that means...
Mechanically mean anything?
I think that means that you can't... there's like... your last two health are like permanent.
You're you can't recover past that. Like yeah. you are at a point.
If you're
going
to use a recovery item, it has to be before you hit.
You have to use it ahead of that.
Yeah.
Well, one live, two blank probably means that we're running the odds and we shoot ourselves and then we go from there.
Yeah. Lock first?
Well, too late now. I clicked it.
Whoops.
Come on, listen, here we go.
May the odds be ever in your favor.
Woo! Woo! You hold on to the item. One blank, one live.
50-50. Then now you lock, shoot. If it misses, you shoot again. You get the one, right? Question right. is whether or not we toss one of our two saws on this one without knowing for sure.
So you think we take the shot at him?
I think so.
On the 50-50, right?
We have we have the handcuffs, right?
Well, because then also, worst case scenario, well, he's handcuffing. I guess that... Well, you would know, I guess, if we didn't do the handcuff, shot him with a live bullet, then he's getting a blank, and then he can skip our next turn, right. Is what you'd be giving him. Right. So, yeah, I say we handcuff, we shoot, because really I think a lot of this round is going to be you're trying to inflict damage. You're trying to get ahead of the damage game.
Yeah.
So if we can ensure that we're getting two, or at least one, that is probably...
Points on the board.
Points on the board. All right. So do you think we've got two of these? But we only get four items total, right? Like we're not getting another.
No, we're not getting another one. I think save it until we have a more secure situation because we have plenty. There's plenty of health to go. We could still use both of them.
There's plenty of health to go, and I feel like that's maybe. It leaves a little in your back pocket for like, we need some stuff to happen. Also, right. If it's a blank, we get
then
to use
it
anyway.
Yeah, exactly. Oh,
right.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Okay. So now we know
it's a blank.
One blank, so we just do this.
Weep.
And that resets the board.
Ooh.
We do get more items. Is it four per round?
Oh my god.
Oh shit, Cado.
Okay, cool. Well, that's good to know.
Okay, I didn't really. Wait. 4 and 4? Is that what that set was?
Yeah. Good catch. I had trouble, but so... you're right. It was half. It's still 50-50.
And I guess in theory, if we looked at it, you could write down it and you could decipher the pattern.
Is that the pattern?
You know, you mean back to... Well,
I feel like if it
more
was...
Or less, is it starting... It has to be starting from left or right, right?
I don't think it is. Because then...
Oh, it says they go in a random order. Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. Okay.
Because if it were, then you just know the order, right?
Right.
There's no logic game. It's just... Do you remember what order they went in?
Right. So then this one is Rax... The shotgun ejects the current shell. Right. I don't think we want to do that. We want to do that when there's fewer...
Yeah, fewer options.
Fewer options.
There's 8. It's a 50-50. We can lock and shoot him. And then we have some more information.
We know a little bit more?
Yeah.
All right.
All right, one off the board.
3 live, 4 blank. Reduces his odds of being able to use his double.
Do we rack one just to make the odds different?
Just to reduce the numbers? Yeah. I think that's not a bad idea. Because then that increases our odds of wanting to use the magnifying glass.
Right, yeah.
To see what's in there.
Live.
Okay. 2 live, 4 blank. Well, at this point, we probably do it to ourselves, right? That's the numbers game.
That is the numbers game.
And we have the health to spare. Okay. 3 blank, 2 live. And we probably do it again, right? Although he's got 2, he does have 2 magnifying glasses.
I think
glasses.
This might be where we use our magnifying glass. Because there's 3 blank and 2 live, you said?
Yeah. No, 2 live, 3 blank.
2 live, 3 blank. That one was live.
Okay, so now obviously we use this.
Yeah.
Oh, kind of the title of this says Daddy's Dogma.
What?
Also, it's probably worth, we should have done this at the top, and apologies. Do you want to put like a text descriptor on here that is like a content warning for what? Yeah. Like, would be the appropriate phrase? And like suicidal ideation? Like, I'm open to what the proper terminology should be there. No, self-harm.
That's the thing. I thought I hit save. Hold on. Weird.
We'll pause till we get all this up.
Yeah.
Gundana, this also feels like something Twitch itself should be auto-adding. The game is blast yourself in the face with a shotgun. It's true. We should have caught that ahead of time. That is on me. I will take that L for not putting that in at the top. And yes, does the game self-identify as this is what this is and probably lets you make an informed decision? For sure. But sort of the thing we can go above and beyond and should make sure we do. Instead, we can just have the club vibes get us there.
Okay, that should be right now.
you want to put it like in the, can you like put it like in the corner of the, like the video?
Yeah.
Like on the screen?
I put one in the title too.
Oh, I don't see it on the stream itself. Maybe I'm just.
Oh no, not on the stream. I mean, in the title.
Oh, I see. Gotcha.
I'll put one on screen.
Perfect. Though. Is this game? Oh, I thought people were implying this game was on the eShop. I was like, that can't. I know that Nintendo has let things slip, to a degree of.
Okay.
Perfect. Thank you. Appreciate that, Cado. All right, thanks everyone's patience and for calling that out. We'll make sure that's in the VOD predominantly as well. Okay, so, well, now I'm just, okay. Now that all tags into the video, I think we're ready to shoot that motherfucker, Cado.
Yep.
Be glad. Something about a content warning sliding in from the left made me giggle.
I think he's he can't. Can he heal? No, he can't heal. Oh no, he can't heal.
Well, I think once he's there.
Yeah, look that. Boop.
Two blanks.
Can't
that
heal.
Didn't do anything. He
didn't
just,
do anything.
He's just doing it anyway.
Smoke him if you got him, is the saying.
You know? Yeah, I guess, yeah. Now he's looking.
Oh,
okay,
well.
He's feeling confident.
I mean, he looked. He knows. It'd be foolish.
Okay, so now there's one live, two blanks.
He has another magnifying glass. Is it back to us, though?
Yeah. So we want to use both of these to get us back up.
Yeah.
Twiling 95, clearing the board to get more items later. Yeah, but I mean... One, two... You get 8 spaces. So yes, one life, two blank. The odds are in the blank's favor. We should probably do that because we'd rather have the coin. Well, he can't do that much damage to us.
No.
All he can do is go through the rack and see if it's one, like he can get to the one live, but we probably want to hold on. Well, I don't know. He's just 1 HP now, right?
Yeah, I believe next shot kills. So, there's two ways to think about it. If you shoot yourself, you're more likely to hit a blank. That means we get to go again, and then we take the 50-50. Or we shoot him and hope it's the live one, but that's less likely to happen, right? So I think we should pick ourselves.
Especially with
blank.
This much.
And if it isn't a blank, it's not. Then the last two are blanks. And so it just wastes his two can items, right?
Right.
Like he'll probably just rack through them instead of, or like shoot whatever. Like I don't know. Maybe he'll check because he can't remember.
Plus, either we're in a position of power here. We don't have to gamble on a 1 in 3 scenario. We
exactly. Can...
Okay. All right. Yeah. Okay. Now it is a 50-50.
50-50.
And we probably take that. We take the coin flip and see if we can end this.
Yeah. Yeah. Because then again, if we're wrong, it's not... We're not nowhere close to losing, so...
Dix, AVD, are we sure they only have 1 health, or is their health just obscured now? Oh, it might be. So this might have been an instance where we should have used...
Maybe. I haven't...
I don't know how
it works. Feels like... Yeah, I'm curious. Because it does show two little...
Okay. Oh. Well, we didn't use it anyway.
Wait, did we miscount?
Maybe. I thought there was one live one left.
I thought there was one live one left too. Yeah.
Oh man, this really puts us in control of the board here.
Yeah.
Three live, two blank.
Either way, we lock him up.
Yeah.
Just, you don't get turns.
Not here, sir. So if we think it's just one shot and then yeah. It ends, like, we're probably just gambling on firing over and over, right? Right.
Yeah,
I like think instead so. Of like.
Well, here's the thing: we have magnifying glass. Do we use one just to see, and then we know? Because if not, then they're taking 3-2. It was it 3-2.
Yeah, three live, two blank.
I think, given the fact that we have handcuffs on, we shoot him.
Yeah.
Because then it's three live, one blank, right? After that.
All right. Yeah, I love the little animation.
Three live, one blank.
Three live, one blank. So the odds are very in the favor of the next one being.
Here's magnifying glass. Now
we
right?
We can magnify it just to like, why not just be sure?
Because there's only two options. Instead of there being two that are like wibbly, there's like either it's a live one or not. But then we know
it's a live one.
Live one. Just
and
just
now,
in case,
I mean,
it's
too, we might as well be might sure, as, right? We might as well.
We're not
just
gonna use this. We're not taking this with us, you know.
Goodbye, dear friend. In the club.
In the club.
Oh, I love that. I love that you click each one individually.
Wow.
Oh man, I'd ask handcuff him just for kicks. We should have. We should have.
This really add insult to injury. Just get an achievement.
Congratulations, Pat.
Interesting.
That's a neat little experimental game. I kind of wish there was more, a little more. Maybe the gun part would, you know, the gimmick would tire eventually. But I actually do think there would be a ton of interesting mind games in the multiplayer version of Gunshot Roulette.
Yeah, I'm curious how they. It seems like the cashier's score. I wonder how they like calculate that. Is that starting from a certain number and then subtracting when you use items, or?
Double or nothing. Well, I mean, I might as well click it.
You might as well look. Yeah, you might as well.
I mean, we got the luck of Balatro on our side right now. One and done.
Oh, I played so much fucking Balatro in the car on the way to the Eclipse.
Oh yeah.
How did that
go for you?
I hate the black deck. Is the last like regular deck that you unlock. It's fucked, and it took me like 7 hours to beat. It's
But you did it.
I did do it eventually. It's minus one hand. Oh, that's new.
Oh, whoops.
Well,
am I supposed to? Hold on.
Yeah, you gotta click. Yeah, you gotta look around. You gotta.
There's I didn't things know if to I could click on. Honest, did you see the Balatro patch notes? No.
No, I think they nerfed one of my favorite jokers, though.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So the black deck gives you an extra joker slot, which means instead of 5, you can have 6 jokers. However, you get one less hand, so you're at 3, and one less and the normal amount of discards just 3, which makes the beginning of the game hell, honestly. Because you don't get to take advantage of the extra Joker slot until you're like near the end game. Because you're not going to have six Jokers immediately. Hey, what the fuck is happening?
What's Sophia doing in this game? Locked? Oh, that's the multiplayer mode. That's not in it yet.
Total cash. It's accumulative. It's cumulative. Wait, yeah, what is that? Did you click the pills? The shining.
I think that's what.
You want some fucking loot?
Consumed the double or nothing pills, chasing losses. What are you trying to say about my minor gambling habits, video game? When I lose a dollar because a field goal was missed, sometimes I play another dollar.
The skip Joker tags being free. They skip token joke skip for rare Joker is free now?
The sequel to Pat.
Pats 2. I'm on basic stakes for all of them, except for my red deck has two stakes up.
All right, more beer to start. That's good. That's good for us.
The fuck is that?
I don't know. It's a lot of items to start.
Yeah. It seems like he's got two of those things. What the fuck
three is live, that? Three blank.
Right.
40% chance to regain two charges, if not lose one charge. Expired medicine.
Amazing. That's spectacular.
Oh, is it four blank? Did I get that wrong? Three live, four blank? Thank you. Well, I mean, if we're playing the odds, then I guess it's just we I guess we could we'll start with us.
Okay. Is his face different?
That was a blank.
His face is different.
That was alive. Now he's looking.
Why is his face different?
I don't know. Ah, damn it. Okay, well.
I'm gonna have some expired medicine.
So now there's two blank.
Three blank?
I lost track.
It was 3-4 and we got hit twice. So 1-4. 1-3? 1-3? Oh, you use the medicine first.
Oh, I guess you're right. Should I just use it anyway?
Yeah, why not? I'm sure it's still good.
Oh, that didn't seem good.
Okay. Yeah, that's cool. That's cool.
I don't, Cado, I don't know where we're at. What is that? What does he have over there?
I don't know. I don't know what that does. 1-3.
1-3. All right. Well, I guess we blank.
I think we have to lock and shoot is what I would do here.
And shoot ourselves?
No, shoot him. Lock, because if it hits a blank, then we can go again.
Oh, right. Yeah, I hear you.
But we're low on health. We can't take the gamble on it even possibly being us.
Yeah.
Have to hope. Yeah, his head's more three-dimensional.
Okay.
1-2.
Two blanks. Well, we could just...
rack it. Yeah. Because then it's either a 50-50 or we know.
So now it's
50-50.
So we probably shoot him, right?
Yeah, we either shoot him or we
could,
take
or it. Or we could just go all we just go all the way with our drink the and then we know.
Yeah, and then we know. And then we know.
Yep.
Knowing it's half the battle.
Okay, perfect.
Now we got some damage on the board. Did we miscount again?
Fuck.
Did we miscount again? It. I feel like we keep losing bullets. What the fuck is that?
I don't know. We need a third person here doing the math. 4 and 4.
4 and 4. I feel drowned. I have it. I this is just water, but I feel day drunk because I got to bed at 4 in the morning after driving for 4 hours.
Steal an item and use it immediately. A mysterious voice gives you insight from the future.
I mean, we have to click it.
Yeah.
That way we need to know.
Sixth shell live round. Okay. Six equal live.
It was worth it. Impulsive spending. It was worth it.
Wait, did that just eject a shell?
No.
No, these are just what's left on the table, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, I was looking down at my notebook.
So okay, it's a 50.
Use that right
it's
now.
A 50-50 right now, right?
Yes. I wonder if you can use steal item to steal his steal item.
If you do, that's worth it because then he doesn't get the use, right? And then you can still use it. Let's see if they stack.
We should find out, right?
Yeah.
No! It doesn't let you take it!
Okay, what does that thing do?
Swaps the poli- Oh! I ran out of time!
It's timed? Well, let's take our medicine and hope for the best.
Okay.
Yum. Woo. 40% of the time, it works every time.
He's got a lot of items to work with, though. We're really do a blend through our items.
Yeah, this is a very different vibe from the first one. It feels like
It's not good. It's not good. Content warning: taking L's in the second round.
50-50.
Well, we could rack it and see if that gives us slightly better odds on something.
Sixth shell is the thing.
Right.
So we have to do. Now it's fifth.
Okay.
Shit! We should have shot him. All right.
I know. 3 L's, 4 blanks, and this—that was the first shell, right?
Yep.
So 1. Okay. So now 3 live, 4 blank.
Shoot ourselves.
We probably, yeah. God damn it.
Yep.
All right. So now that's the second shot.
His head
he
is
found out some information.
His head is a sphere now. I have figured it out.
He's got. We were so dominant last round. Oh.
Oh. But.
Okay. 1 live.
He locked us.
He did.
We've been locked.
What does this one do? Oh, it changes the polarity. He knows there's so many blanks now. Shit.
Let's just hope he guessed wrong, because this is. Pure blank.
One shot. Damn it.
Oh, son of a bitch.
But now and it's he our can turn. Switch in the next one. It's over. Game's over.
No, now's our turn. Now's our turn.
Oh. So there's 1 live round left, right?
Is it the sixth round?
Wait, what are we on? Shit, there's too many numbers to keep track of.
He shot us twice? He shot us twice. This is the sixth round.
Okay. So the sixth round has to be live.
Right. Because the first one was ejected. We shot ourselves. He shot
us. We're shooting him.
He shot us twice. Wait. No, we were off by one. It was the fifth round. Ha ha! He didn't know.
So now there's only a blank left, right? Only blanks, but he can switch the polarity.
Yeah, but it's our turn. So if it's a blank.
So we can skip him.
Yeah. We know. The polarity only switches for the round that he does it on.
Right. And now this, we should just do it again. Okay. Whew! We're holding on. We held on! Had me in the first half, not gonna lie.
Yeah. Okay, we've got polarity switcher.
Only two.
Oh, that's horrible.
Three and three. Okay.
Yeah, double check the polarity thing. It reverses it for the one currently chambered, right?
Correct. Well, we might as well see what the future has to hold. Fourth shell, live round. Okay. We are on.
Interesting.
Shell one.
It's a 50-50. We know one of them is fourth down.
And he's got some real options over there. He can reverse. He can look at, like, he really has our number because.
So it's no longer. He can look
and then reverse it.
So statistics are a funny thing. It's no longer a 50-50 because we know one of them is not in contention, right?
That's true.
We should be considering this as it's currently three blanks.
That was four, right? The four is the live round?
Fourth, yeah. It would be normally three and three, but now it's actually two lives, three blanks is what could be this first shell.
I think our only real option here is to just bet on raw luck and to shoot him twice. But I think we're screwed either way, right? Because
okay, if we shoot him and it's wrong, that makes the odds 2-2. It's another 50-50 on his end, but he can look and know, and then
right. I think the magnifying glass screws us. I don't think we can win.
I think if we shoot him, he's at one. If he knows, he can always swap it. Yeah, we've lost.
We need the AI to make a mistake.
Yeah, we need the AI to not use the magnifying glass. But for this one, here's the thing: do we reverse the polarity so it's a more likely shot because it's 3-2? Can you put it back down? Have we figured this out? Can you click in the middle, maybe? Can you click the gun?
I'm screwed, Cado. I'm screwed.
You've already made the choice. We should have reversed the polarity just in case, but... Yeah, polarity shoot was the right move. Turns out it wasn't. Odds-wise, it was. But now he kills us. Because he's gonna look.
Yes. He's doing it. He's okay. Oh, the game is doing the obviously correct move.
Yeah.
Okay, but is there like a quick time event I can use? Why
even? That seems so rude.
Not nice.
So this is a little more interesting. That first game definitely, I felt like the mix of items ended up getting to a point where you could always figure it out logically if you like.
There was a lot of bored. Like yes. Hoarding, like you, like the handcuffs let you do too much. Eventually, the our opponent really had no choice but to just. It was just waiting out. When are we gonna fire this last shot? Take out this boy. Whereas these new items at least introduced a little more variability. Anyway, that's Buckshot Roulette. That game's neat. Maybe we'll come back and check out this double or nothing mode another time to see if we can make it a little bit further and see what else the game has to offer. But yeah, this is out now on PC. I know they said they're working on console versions. And like Cado mentioned, there is a version on itch.io. And if you want to support the developer over there, the Steam updates, which is what we're looking at here, will be coming to the itch.io version. I think you said on the 18th. Was the date that was,
yes, listed. So. Yeah, yeah, we'll get the new mode should be coming on April 18th.
Let's see. What else is happening this week? This morning I recorded something that you'll see next month. There's some behind the scenes stuff happening at Remap for a collaboration we're doing that will make more sense down the line. It'll seem very obvious in hindsight, but it's not something we can chat about at the moment. But there's some work that we're doing that would be normally stuff that you would see during a week that instead is being recorded and will release in a different later week. On. So April's a little funky as we line all that stuff. But I did one of those this morning. Rob did one recently as well, and I've got a couple more to record. But tomorrow we're doing an interview that's Godzilla related that I don't want to jinx, but we're very excited about. That will probably come out next week would be my assumption because we're not recording it till Wednesday morning. But we'll have Remap Radio. We'll have more Daddy's Dogma on Friday, and we'll see if we can sneak something else in between now and then. But that is sort of Remap for the week, and I think that's gonna do it for this stream. Cado, Destiny, the Final Shape,
yeah,
thumbs up or thumbs down? How you feeling about where Destiny is headed?
I'm hyped.
A little bit we've seen. You're hyped?
I'm hyped. It looks
how
neat.
Much does it take for you to get hyped and to convince yourself?
I mean, I was hyped when they added fucking Strand, you know, like it's it was good. It was fun. I still had a good time in Lightfall, even though I then just stopped playing.
Yeah.
Well, I think here's the weird thing about that game, too, is that like I don't think I was ever the audience that was going to stick around no matter what. Once I had access to other games, it was my forever game when I was poor. And I had maybe one game purchase a year. So like Destiny 1 back on the fucking PS3, I like played the shit out of that game. That was my only game. These days, because of our job, because we have more access to other games, like I'm always jumping around to other things when I can. I have less of a thing that I like need to go back to every week.
And that makes sense.
Destiny kind of has fallen into me since like starting this job. Into the like realm of I check in on the big expansions, I do the raid, and then maybe if I have time, I might check in on some of the weekly stuff. But for the most part, I get the like news reports. What happened in the world? Like I'm getting the story beats, but like not really in it in that way. And I could never be because it's too much time investment for the amount of stuff that we check out for like our stuff, right?
Yeah, so I think of no better way to end this stream than you just ruined a lot of people's days by saying that Destiny came out on the PlayStation 3. So that's just a great time.
It's fucked up. I didn't have this job when it came out. I was in
what is time?
I was in grad school.
I don't know what time is. Let's not think about it too much.
No.
And instead, go on with our days. As always, you can support everything we do over at remapradio.com. Your support allows us to do streams like this and all the other stuff we do over at Remap. So thanks for your support. Hope you enjoyed the stream. We'll be back at the very latest on Friday with another day of Dragon's Dogma. And we'll give everyone a shout if we're able to sneak something in between now and then. But until then, bye.